Dina? Order.
Thank you very much, Honorable Speaker. Can I respond to question 8 from the DA on energy and water crisis in Ekurhuleni, Germiston in particular? The challenge of municipalities across the country is an aging infrastructure, is water leaks, is illegal connection, but also is lack of investing the retail sale of water to the water infrastructure. And therefore, it becomes impossible for people to get water as they are expected to. But also the user pay, where people don't want to pay for services that they've received from municipalities. It is against that background that we have advised municipalities to enforce bylaws. For instance, in each and every town, you see car wash, so many, but they are not even metered. And therefore, there's also a lot of non-revenue water. Water is just running down the street and not reaching the beneficiaries. So when we were in Ekurhuleni for the imbizo of presidential imbizo on the 23rd, the matter of water leaks was raised and the municipality gave a comprehensive plan on how they are dealing with water issues. So the honorable member can get that plan on closing water leaks and ensuring that people or the community around Ekurhuleni gets. Honorable Speaker, honorable members of this august house, ladies and gentlemen, nina malunga bekekileyo wowiso noqimbo mthetho. I welcome this opportunity to make a statement to this House on matters pertaining to the safety of dams in South Africa. In the past 4 weeks, we have witnessed the terrible disaster that affected the community of Riverlands in the Swartland local municipality, where 4 dams failed and destroyed houses as well as damaged municipal infrastructure. Umonakalo oye wabonakala phaya awuthetheki, abantu baye bashiyeka besentlungwini ngenxa yokuthi la madamu aye asisa amanzi amaninzi. The unfortunate disaster brought attention to the issue of dam safety in South Africa and how this affects communities residing downstream of the rivers of these dams. Ukhuseleko ke lwamadami luxanduva lwalowo nalowo othe wokha idam kufuneka alihoye aliqoqoshe kakuhle. Honorable members of this House will recall how the community of Charlesville and Itumeleng townships were displaced from their houses and lives were lost when tailing dam failed in the Free State town of Jagersfontein in September 2022. Kodwo ye ulikajenu batho ba Freestata ha ba ile ba le hobane hule wa hlokahala batho wa tsama matlo. The 2 recent unfortunate incidents make it important for me to highlight the issues pertaining to the safety of dams in South Africa. Amadam ke afuneka akhuselwe ngabo baye bawomba. Chapter 12 of the National Water Act, as well as the regulation published in Government Gazette, requires that an owner of a dam that meets the requirement of a dam with a safety risk to register such a dam and to comply with all other regulations pertaining the type and the size of the dam. Over and above the registration of the dam, the owner must apply for a dam safety license to construct, alter, and repair the dam before construction can commence. Awuvuki ucinga into yoba mawolonge izidamu lo nyuse. Kufuneka uqale ufune imvume yokwenza loo nto. The owner of the dam must also appoint approved professional person. Amadami ke afuna injiniyeri nobuchwepheshe khona ukuze kwenziwe umsebenzi. And that person must have been registered with the engineers expect to conduct compulsory dam safety evaluation at least every 5 years. Each dam must provide or submit to the department the dam safety assessment. The National Water Act defines a dam with a safety risk as a dam with minimum vertical wall height of 5 meters and capable of storing more than 50 megaliters of water. A dam that does not meet these requirements does not fall under the category. According to the register of dams with a safety risk, in our register, we have 5,703 dams. Out of that, 323 dams are dams of Department of Water and Sanitation. The department makes sure that we keep all our dams being regulated. Approximately, whilst our dams are few, 87% of total volume of water is stored in our dams. The 5,703, due to the size of other dams, are not of the magnitude of what our dams are. That is why we don't understand if the owners are unable to maintain their dams. Over the past 2 years, our department, the DWS, has issued non-compliance instruction, directives and directives to owners of dams who are found to be non-compliant with the regulation. However, it takes time for court to process such matters of non-compliance by dam owners. We have also ensured increased compliance by organs of state such as water boards, as well as ESCOM and mining sector, because they do own dams. This shows that we are not only targeting non-compliant private dam owners, we are also focusing on dams that belong to state, including those that are owned by my own department. The National Water Act put responsibility for safety of dams to the owner. Wonke umnini dam makathathe uxanduva uba kuye kwenzeke umonakalo, mayibe nguye ke olungisa lo monakalo. It was found that none of the dams in the Riverlands municipality have been registered in the department, let alone a permit. So all these things will happen, especially as we approach summer. Heavy rains will see those dams failing or collapsing. The current owner of the four dams is the Department of Rural Development and Land Reform. I have submitted a preliminary report on investigation to Minister Ndlozi. However, I must clarify this house that when the Department of Land and Rural Development, when they bought or procured that farm, they found those dams on the farm. They did not construct the dams, but also they've leased out that farm. So the previous owners, when they were constructing those four dams on the stream, they did not apply for any permission. But the person that is going to be reliable for this, it should be the landlord, which is the Department of Land and Rural Development. Working in collaboration with Rural Development, we have rehabilitated all the four dams that have collapsed, because we don't want those remnants of failed dams to further cause injuries to our people. On the issue of Jagersfontein tailing dam that failed on the 11th of September 2022, our department has concluded criminal investigation and the docket has been handed over to the National Prosecuting Authority. The responsible prosecutor has acquired all statements and affidavits. The matter is expected to be enrolled in 2025. However, there are some humanitarian interventions that have been made. Some houses have been handed over to those who lost their houses. My department has also appointed University of Pretoria and the University of Witwatersrand to conduct technical forensic investigation on the failure of Jagersfontein tailing storage facility. The report may be used in the criminal proceedings and therefore cannot be made public until we are advised by NPA. One of the roles of my department is to ensure water use license, to ensure that water resources are utilized sustainably and equitably. For example, the Middle Litaba in Limpopo catchment, it is water stressed, and community in the catchment have raised concern as to whether some users are over or abstracting water from the three rivers that feed Middle Litaba Dam, resulting in insufficient water available for others. To address this concern, we have established a ministerial advisory committee chaired by retired Judge President Bernard Ngwepe, who is being assisted by various experts to ensure that they give us a report by January, because we cannot allow anyone who blocked the water not to get to our people. Just because one is running a farm or a plant, they must ensure that they allow water to go down, especially in those who are in downstream. We are also working on plans to build additional infrastructure to enable available resources in the middle Litaba system to be supplemented. Furthermore, we'll be negotiating possible reduction in water in the interim whilst the investigation is on. Let our people not be disadvantaged by that. Honorable Speaker, apart from strengthening the internal capacity, we have also employed a lot of water experts and engineers. We are working with the Engineering Council of South Africa to find ways of making it easier for young engineers and professionals to acquire necessary skills. That is why you also have bursary on those who are interested in studying a water engineer. As part of the recommendation in the Riverlands, my report to the department has prepared a notice to be published in the Government Gazette to call on all those who have dams to register their dam before they could be prosecuted. And Chair, as I close, we must ensure that the notice will give all dam owners and those who wish to construct dams to apply for the license. And those who already have dams, they must also apply for the license so that they are recorded and registered accordingly for them to be able to account on those dams. A media awareness campaign, including both print and electronic media, is being planned by the department. We'll also be engaging with organizations representing sectors as agriculture and mining, because a lot of the dams are within the agricultural sector. Furthermore, we'll engage the Department of Cooperative Governance, traditional leaders, and National Treasury to find a way of assisting municipalities that own dams and require support to ensure that their dams are safe and compliant. This intervention will be extended to other state departments to ensure that all dam owners are compliant. I thank you very much, Honorable Speaker.
Welcome to LT Celeb Times. That's it for now, guys. And please tell us what you think about this on the comment section below. And thank you so much for watching.